Hello, in this video I'm going to be going over the steps to create a logo using Stable Diffusion. So before we dive into the process, I just want to kind of give you a general overview. About 90% of the work that we'll be doing today will be using image to image. We will do a little text to image, but most of it will just kind of be modifying and adapting upon a previous image. The process itself is very iterative. Basically, we'll kind of be leading the model to the final result. And just as a little tip, be sure to save the parameters of your outputs whenever you run them. That way, if you ever want to go back and make any sort of modifications to the logo, you'll at least have all those parameters handy for that. So before we start interfacing with Stable Diffusion, we're going to go ahead and set the general composition of the logo in a photo editing software. So I'm using Pixelmator. You can use Photoshop, you can use Canva. There's lots of options out there. But basically what we're doing is trying to get the lettering correct as well as the general colors of what we want for our final logo to look like. For our example, I'm just gonna use the letters A and I. And then just so you know, I set the canvas size on here to 1024 by 1024 as we'll be using the Stable Diffusion XL model. And since that is what the image is trained upon or the model is trained upon, I found that this will generally produce a little bit better of results if we use that same resolution. So I'm going to be using Automatic 1111 for this process. Now, as I said earlier, we're just going to want to go ahead and set the and save the text output of the image generation. So we'll have that handy whenever we are, if we ever want to make any modifications of the logo. So I went ahead and uploaded my composition of the words AI. And for the prompt, I'm kind of going to be helping the model understand what this image is and what I want from it. So I'm just going to go ahead and say a photo of the letters AI. And I want it kind of melting and have some complementary highlights to it. To kind of make it a little bit more interesting looking. Now I want to go ahead and make sure there's no signatures or trademarks associated with the logo in order to add anything to the output here. Now, whenever it comes to some of the options on here, we're just going to go ahead and set it to 1024 by 1024 since we're using Stable Diffusion XL. And for the batch count, I like to do 4 at a time. This way I can kind of look at the 4 outputs and decide which one's best and then further modify that. So just to go over the prompt again, I'm putting in what it is that the what this photo is and then kind of leading it to where I want it to go. So let's go ahead and click generate. Okay, so here's the first generation. It's really not all that good as far as the outputs here, and that's kind of to be expected. So what that means is we kind of need to make a few changes to our parameters or run a few more generations. So I'm going to boost the CFG scale just a little bit so it will follow my prompt a little bit more. And then as far as the denoising strength, I'm going to also increase that just a little bit more. So the CFG scale is how closely the model will follow my text prompt. And the denoising strength is how much it should follow this image versus my text prompt. So I'm trying to put more weight on the text prompt than the image itself. So let's go ahead and generate another batch of images here. So with the modified output here, we kind of see this one's starting to look a little bit more stylized. So we're gonna go ahead and modify upon this one here. So I'm basically just going to click this and then send it to the image to image tab here. So it's gonna basically overwrite this, and now this will be the new reference image that we're going with. And I'm going to go ahead and actually change this prompt just a little bit because I want to get something in here. Orange colors, just kind of make it a little bit more because it doesn't really seem like it's getting much as far as the complementary highlights. I see a little bit of the melting, and I'm also going to surround this in a parentheses to kind of put more weight on this certain prompt. So let's go ahead and generate 4 more images. Okay, so now we just generated 4 more images, and as we can see here, it's really starting to take a more creative focus on the output. So here is one image, another, and then this one. So definitely some cool things going on here. I'm not sure exactly what I have in mind for the output, but I kind of like what's going on here. So let's go ahead and toss this over to the image-to-image tab, and then we're gonna go ahead and just generate further on this one. Okay, now here's our next batch of images here. So now we can really see that this orange is starting to take more of a precedence in the logo itself. I think that this one's pretty cool because it's kind of really pulling in that melting prompt that we added here and generating some really cool things. All right, so now we can go ahead and toss this one in the image. You know what? I'm going to try to change it. So I like this melting. I'm going to take out this complementary highlights, and I'm going to try to see where this will take us. So I want to bring in the word pixelated to see if we can kind of get more of a different appearance here. So we're just going to go ahead and do a batch output of 4 more and see where the model takes us. Okay, so here's the next batch. This one's pretty wild. So this definitely, we can see some of the melted characteristics in it, but now it kind of looks, yeah, it's got that pixelated appearance to it. This one, it really depends on what it is that you're looking for with a logo. But some of these are definitely quite unique in their appearance. So let's go ahead and do this one. You know what? Maybe let's go ahead and kind of change some things up here. So instead of melted and orange colors and pixelated, I'm just going to put in fire. See if we can kind of generate some flames off this, because it kind of has this like kind of looking like holes and such. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so here's the next batch that we have. So now we can see that it kind of lost all the pixelation and it is straight up just looking like holes in a fire on the letter. So this is definitely, you know, whether or not I wanted this sign, I wasn't expecting this. So perhaps we can put in back in the words pixelated. And then maybe what we can also do too is mess around with some of this denoising strength. Let's kind of change these up because I want this to be a little bit more creative and follow my text prompt a little bit less. So let's go ahead and generate this and see where we go. All right, so here's the next batch of images. Now this one I think looks really cool. We could definitely go with that. This might be a little too pixelated for what I had in mind, but this one here I think is a very cool looking image that we could definitely either modify upon further or kind of just go with it. So we're just going to go ahead and click that and put it back to the image to image tab here, and we can continue modifying this. However, I'm not going to do that anymore for this video, but I think that this output here is pretty cool. So it's a far cry from where we started. So just as a reminder, we started here with just a simple AI that's in blue. And now this is what we have for a logo. Two completely different looking images, but still pretty legible. We can, of course, still read that it has the letters A and the I. They're connected. Now, whether or not you'd want that there, you could definitely do some very basic photo editing and then bring it back over to the image-to-image tab to clean it up or do some in-painting as well, too. So that's how to create a logo based on just a couple of letters. Now let's go ahead and switch gears. I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to create a logo with an icon next to it. So when going to the text to image tab, if you wanted to do something like a coffee mug, you would just put in, you know, an illustration, a coffee mug, basic colors. So it makes it look well for a logo, and then on a white background. This way, it's a little bit easier for the model on a future iteration if it doesn't have to remove the background or kind of compensate for that. So I went ahead and set this to 1024 by 1024 for the base model here. And here's an image of a coffee mug. Whether or not we'd want to use that for a logo, we definitely could. Now, whenever you do compose this in a photo editing software, you can just copy it and then create a new canvas for 1024 by 1024. and then I'm gonna just paste this in here, and I'm gonna use this program's background remover. Again, there are online tools that do the same process, but then we can just downsize it and then put the word coffee next to it. And then we could use this and start to modify a logo. Again, we're doing this because Stable Diffusion, that's asking a lot from the model to try to get these things all proportioned correctly. So it's much easier to do this ourselves in a photo editing software tool if we wanted to get the right composition set. So then we could just use this, and then we'll just go ahead and save this again as an output as a JPEG here. So if we go to the image to image tab, I'm just going to upload my new image here, and then I'm just going to say it's a photo of a coffee mug along with the word coffee. And this one, I'm gonna try to lead the model in a certain direction. So say perhaps a simple design, coffee beans maybe, so it makes sense. And then let's go ahead and just generate a batch of 4 images and see what we have with this new sort of rudimentary logo. All right, so here's the outputs just based on this prompt, and then the outputs. So here's a really cool, simple looking logo, just based on our original image here. I mean, this is what we provided, and here's something that actually looks pretty good that we can modify upon further. This one, as we can see, the Stable Diffusion model has is kind of not that great whenever it comes to text. And I found that with longer words, it is kind of struggling with that. So if your logo is shorter, it definitely will be a little bit more robust of a solution here. This one I thought was really cool. Unfortunately, the lettering's kind of a little bit off, but it's just something to keep in mind. You know, if we wanted to try something like this, we could try to, you know, even if something as simple as copying this image and bringing it into a photo editor, and then just basically cutting this, moving it over to get the right letters back in there again, and then you could send it back to image and modify upon it and see if you can get this logo exactly how you want. Here's another one, pretty decent, simple logo here, and there's all 4 of them. And of course, you know, you could generally play around with the CFG scale and denoising until you get the results that you're looking for. Now, one other thing I just wanted to briefly mention was using reference images. So sites like Pixabay or Pexels have lots of clip art available on them, and they're under the Creative Commons 0 license, so you're free to use and adapt upon them. So here was an image that I found on there for just a picture or a clip art of a fish. I believe that's what showed up here. And I wanted to kind of develop that into a logo for like a bait company or like a lure. So basically I did that same exact process. I pasted this into a 1024 by 1024 canvas and then continuously modified upon this image until I got something that was representative of a lure. Now, you know, this could definitely work for a logo or a mark that could be next to a word, you know, Bob's Tackle, whatever it might be. So there's definitely some other creative ways that you can use reference images with logo generation. So that's it with creating logos with Stable Diffusion. I hope that this video was helpful. If so, please hit the thumbs up and consider subscribing. And of course, if you have any questions, please use the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, and take care.